I joined members of the Donaghadee Historical Society and their chairman, Harry Allen, for a cruise to Campbeltown. We were to travel on the 54-year-old historic passenger ship Balmoral. During the winter months, Balmoral had been fitted with new engines, partly paid for by the Heritage Lottery Fund. She is now 3 tons lighter and 3 knots faster, with a top speed of 18 knots. After Balmoral got underway, I went to a very windy bridge to ask Captain Lee about the new engines.
When you got the new engines in this year, could you have had them worked directly from here? Or did you deliberately have them that they still worked remotely for the to keep the ship as it used to be?
Well, yes to both.
Yeah.
Yes, we could have had them.
Yeah.
But decided not to.
Yeah.
On two grounds, really. Apart from the fact it makes the ship look more authentic having the telegraphs,
yeah.
It also cuts out a potential area of problem, which is any control system you put in. And as it is, the control system is tried and tested. It's been there for 50 odd years.
Yeah, I remember with the old siren engines you had to have two men. One at the back of each one of them pulling the big levers. With these new engines down below, when they receive the telegraph information, does it take two men down there still?
Just one man now.
And is it just physically demanding, or do you just...
No. It's got a little short control lever about that long.
Yeah, in other words, what you could have had up here, really. Yeah.
Absolutely. I would have had two levers up here.
Yeah.
Each side.
I imagine it's taken you a while to get used to the new engines compared to the old ones because of the difference in sound and quieter. And
the quietness. The quietness is the big problem.
You don't know
because
what they're
doing? I don't think any of us realised how much we used our ears to tell what was happening down below.
Yeah.
Manoeuvring the ship.
Yeah, yeah. Because there's always a delay from when you give the command and something happens.
Previously, you could hear. I could hear when the engine fired. I could hear when it's picked up. I could tell how much power I was getting. I could even tell which way it was going.
Right.
Now I haven't got a clue. The engine's just running full the time. And I can hardly hear it running.
That's right. It's the gearbox that does the reversing, whereas the old engine, you stop
them.
Right,
the engine.
And then start. But I suppose they're more reliable. It's a pity you couldn't get them locally, or you couldn't get them in Great Britain. You had to go to Sweden for them.
Sure. Denmark,
was it?
Danish,
yeah. Yeah. Too bad that somebody over here, Great Britain, couldn't make.
There just aren't any engine manufacturers making that sort of thing.
Yeah. The old engines, were they scrapped or were they ever going to be used for anything else?
They're of no practical use, really. They're okay as museum pieces, but you couldn't really run them.
Yeah.
If we could have run them, then we'd be running them.
Yeah.
We scrapped them because we couldn't. We could no longer obtain or even make spare parts for them.
Well, let's hope these ones will keep you going for another, what is it, those went in the 1949.
49. So, 53 years out of these,
that'll
be good.
Well, that's good. I'm going to go down and have a look at them. Thanks very much.
No trouble at all.
Bye.
Cheers, pal.
The big Grena diesels were running smoothly, each thumping a massive 800 horsepower into the new shafts and specially designed propellers. The propellers were made in Singapore and somewhat sickle-shaped. The design made for efficiency and quiet running, similar to those of military submarines. After we arrived at Campbeltown, the crew made use of the time there to touch up the paintwork. All too soon our short stay in Campbeltown was over, and it was time to return to the historic Balmoral for our cruise back to Bangor.